So it is a great pleasure and privilege to introduce you to the crew flying us through to Melbourne this afternoon. In command of the aircraft today, we've got your captain, Tim Anderson, joining him in the flight deck, First Officer Mitchell Graham. Fantastic crew taking care of you in the main cabin, starting at the front with Beck. In the centre there is Leah, towards the rear is Ali. Once again, my name is Christopher. In preparation for the safety demonstration, we do ask that you now please pause all electronic devices for this important safety announcement.
Hello and welcome on board this Virgin Australia Boeing 737-800. Please pay close attention while we get you ready for takeoff. As we're ready to leave, fasten your seatbelt low and tight around your hips. To fasten, push both ends together until they click and adjust by pulling the strap until tight. To release, simply lift the buckle. You'll need to keep your seatbelt fastened whenever the seatbelt sign is on. And as always, it's best to have your seatbelt fastened whenever you're seated. The cabin will be pressurized during the flight. But if oxygen is needed, masks will drop from the unit above you. Immediately pull the mask down to start the flow of oxygen. Quickly place it over your nose and mouth and secure the strap. Oxygen will flow without the bag inflating. Breathe normally and remember to fit your mask first and then help others. A life jacket is under or beside your seat. If required, you will need to retrieve it and take it from the plastic bag. Slip the life jacket over your head and pass the strap around your waist. Clip together and tighten by pulling the strap. Once you're outside the aircraft, pull down on the toggles to inflate. And for further inflation, blow into the mouthpieces. There is a light and whistle for attracting attention. The crew will hand out infant and spare adult life jackets. The emergency exits will now be pointed out by the crew. There are two doors at the front of the aircraft, four exits over the wings, and two doors at the rear. Check where your nearest exit is and keep in mind it may be behind you. If there is reduced visibility, follow the escape path lighting to the exits. If we need to evacuate,